In this presentation, we will consider one special problem related to Fibonacci series. So let's get started. We need to write a program to print Fibonacci series up to n number of terms. This is our problem statement. You might ask me this question, where does this term comes from? The term Fibonacci comes from the name of an Italian mathematician, Leonardo of Pisa, also known as Fibonacci. Leonardo of Pisa was an Italian mathematician and was a great Italian mathematician who introduced this series to the world. After knowing where this term comes from, let's now understand what is Fibonacci series. In Fibonacci series, next term is obtained by taking sum of previous two terms. Let's suppose if we want to find out what is the value of fifth term, then the value of fifth term can be obtained from the previous two terms, that is the fourth term and the third term. This simply means you need to add the value of the fourth term and the value of the third term, which means 2 plus 1, which gives us 3. Mathematically, we can say that Fibonacci of n is equals to Fibonacci of n minus 1 plus Fibonacci of n minus 2. If we want to find out the Fibonacci of the fifth term, then this is equals to Fibonacci of the fourth term plus Fibonacci of the third term. Okay? What is so magical about Fibonacci numbers? Obviously, there is something magical about these numbers. Let's see what is so magical about them. Let's suppose we have one 1 by 1 square and then we have another 1 by 1 square. On the top of these two squares, we have a 2 by 2 square and towards left, we have a 3 by 3 square. Towards bottom, we have a 5 by 5 square and then we have an 8 by 8 square. You can see these squares are forming up the Fibonacci series, right? 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13 and so on. Let's say we want to join these two opposite corners with the help of a curve, like this. Similarly, we want to join these two opposite corners with another curve, these two opposite corners with a curve, these two corners with a curve, then these two corners with a curve, and finally, these two corners with a curve. Now, what do you observe in this figure? Here you are forming up a spiral, right? This spiral is also known as Fibonacci spiral. Now you might ask me this question, what is so magical about this Fibonacci spiral? The speciality of this spiral is that you can find this spiral in nature. Like for example, you can find a Fibonacci spiral in this beautiful flower, or you can find it in galaxy. This simply means that nature follows Fibonacci series, right? That is the beauty of Fibonacci series. That is why Fibonacci series is special, because it has lot of applications which you can find out in nature, and that is why we are studying Fibonacci series here. After having the motivation of why we are studying Fibonacci series, let's get back to our problem statement. We need to write a program to print Fibonacci series up to n number of terms. Let's see how the program looks like. Suppose we initialize a by 0 and b by 1. Then after that, we run this for loop from 1 to n, where n is the number of terms. Inside this for loop, you can see we are printing the value of a. And then after that, we calculate the result, which is a plus b. We simply store the value of b inside a. And then after that, we simply store result inside b. In order to understand this code, we need to consider one example. Let's suppose n is equals to 6. In the iteration number 1, value 0 will be printed on the screen. As 1 is less than n, therefore condition is satisfied, we come inside this for loop and print the value of a, that is 0. After that, we calculate the result, which becomes 1, because a plus b, that is 0 plus 1, is 1 only. After that, a becomes 1 and b also becomes 1. Because a will contain the value of b and b will contain the result. In the iteration number 2, value 1 will get printed on the screen because a is equals to 1. And then we calculate the result, which becomes 2, as 1 plus 1 is 2. After that, a will contain the value 1, which is equal to b, and b will contain the result value, which is equals to 2. In the iteration number 3, we print the value 1 on the screen as a is 1, right? After that, result will contain value 3 because 1 plus 2 is 3. A will then contain 2 and B will contain 3. And of course, in the next iteration, 2 will get printed on the screen because A is 2. Result will contain value 5 and then A will contain value 3 and B will contain 5. In the iteration number 5, 3 will get printed on the screen. Result will be 8. A will contain 5 and B will contain 8. And finally, in the iteration number 6, 5 will get printed on the screen. Result will contain value 13 because 5 plus 8 is 13. A will contain the value of B, which is 8, and B will contain result, which is equals to 13. Therefore, the series which will get printed on the screen will be 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, and 5. Right? Now it's time to execute the code. Let's execute this code. Enter the number of terms. Let's say we enter 6. As you can see, total 6 terms will get printed on the screen, and this series is a Fibonacci series, right? Let's say we enter the number 10, then total 10 terms will get printed on the screen, right? Now let's say we enter the number 17, then these are all the terms which will get printed on the screen, and this is a Fibonacci series, right? So as you can clearly see, our code works fine for the Fibonacci series, and therefore, this is the correct code. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.